number 56, is on, and he'll take over on the mound.
Number 56.
Andy Lunsford will stand in, needing to get things started here in the top of the ninth. Here we go with inning number 9 as the first pitch misses for ball one. Out in front of a fastball as this is ripped down the left field line. That's going to be a fair ball. Around first, digging for two now. The throw into second, but he'll be in there with a double. Ryan Andrews will get an opportunity now following the leadoff double.
And with his guys down by a run, at the very least, you need to try to shoot something to the right side. Hopefully get that runner over to third with one out.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And a fastball is hit on the ground towards short. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Javier Barreto will work now on getting that tying run home from second. And a fastball is in there for strike one.
I think he had to take that one because I'm not even sure he saw it.
There's a swing and a ball hit into the air to left center and shallow. Almonte will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two. Dino Rosales will have a shot at driving home that possible tying run that's standing at second. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. And now the wheels spin in that first base dugout.
Oh, that man right there's got to be sweating bullets. Hard to say I blame him at all.
And he'll stay alive here as this is chopped foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. Struck him out, so he'll strand the possible tying run at second, and a great job of working out of trouble as this ball game is over.
Yeah, you know that run in the bottom of the eighth turned out to be the difference maker as they're able to hold on here and get this win in a squeaker.
A tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. So a good job of collectively swinging the bats in this one, but if we had to single out one guy who outshined all others, I think it's the man who stands out right here. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he came through with a couple of hits, but more importantly, that big home run, which really led his guys to this victory.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vasquez. Number 56 will be the new pitcher.
Number 56.
Joe Mahalo will stand in now, and hey, give these guys credit. They're not going down without a fight.
I'll tell you what, they're not too far away from making a game out of this one after all.
Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like he's trying to get a ground ball here. He's coming right after him, trying to get a punch out.
And now a sharply hit ball toward the right side as this gets foul past the coaching box. And he puts a pretty good jolt into this one, high and deep to center. Tanner is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two. And he'll make it up safely to third, so they're at the corners now with two men out. And he is out at the plate, trying to get a little too greedy when he didn't need to be, and this ball game is over.
That's about as economical a save as you're ever going to find. He only threw four pitches, but they're enough to get the job done.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. Time to hand out Topps Player of the Game honors for this one. And guys, I think we can all agree that this fellow right here deserves it more than anybody that took the field in this one.
Yeah, he connected on a couple of long home runs.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for Trenton, number 56.
Johnny McGowan will try again. Two for four in the ballgame. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike.
Well, if there is one worry about a closer throwing this hard, if anyone squares up on a fastball, this game could be tied before you know it.
Throw will not be in time, so good hustle there as now the possible tying run is aboard to lead things off here. Eddie Valdez is at the plate as he looks at ball one. Nervous time now in that third base dugout.
Heck, nervous time up here. My heart's racing and I'm just watching this game.
Called strike and he's behind one and two.
Very patient here to start the at-bat. Maybe even a little too patient because now he's down one and two.
Yeah, and I don't think he's going to get anything better than that to hit.
Richie Santana comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Here's a 1-0. Another fastball. This one he gets by him. It's 1-1.
Boys, that's 99 right through him.
And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now.
A lot of late movement on that fastball. That nearly came back to the outer edge.
Mejia will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two. Sammy Benitez is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one.
Just no chance to pull the trigger on that one. It just got on him too fast.
Almonte is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
Well, maybe a little problem is that they wind up having to burn through the bullpen a little bit. Five pitchers are going to combine to finish off this victory.
A tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. Well, a pretty good offensive show of force in this one. Probably at least a couple of players deserving. But, gentlemen, let's go ahead and give this man the nod.